has requested I do another midnight ramble. Although I say it's midnight, it's more like 5 a.m. Which could either be really, really early or really, really, really late. Depending on where you're coming from, I guess. Once again, I'm filming this on a entirely new device. I am brushing you, apparently. I sold my BlackBerry and got a UI, I don't know how to pronounce it properly, P8, because it has a 8-megapixel camera on the front. And recently I have had technical issues because I tend to lose my temper and throw things. So the camera I have been using, it uses a normal SD card, and the laptop I was using for that SD card died due to a bipolar rage, I call it, which should really just be called a hissy fit. But because of that, I can't use it. Because my main laptop that I used to edit, which when I get in a mood, I make sure I leave the room, does work with SD card. So I thought I would try this camera, and if it works, I might use this one permanently. My normal camera, I can't see the screen on it, so I have to kind of use the reflection in the lens to see if it works. And as you can see in a few videos, it's always like kind of like up here. Now, I thought I would do a bit of personal attention, try some ear-to-ear whispering. I'm assuming the camera, this phone, has stereo sound, otherwise I'm wasting my time here. And I thought I would give you a bit of an update. So, Fuck It Week ended last week, and it was fun to make. I had some really, really good feedback, and the idea was for it to end in a collaboration, which I have all the content for. I have 6 people that joined in, including Minx Laura, Indigo Whisper, Duke Doom ASMR, and a few others. Some are big channels, some are little, and they're all great. Struggling to even get out of bed recently. My mental issues have been re-arising quite somewhat. Hey, you can see the photo of me, the drawing of me and my wife when we were younger that my friend did. Anyway, my work situation isn't great. Affected me more than I thought it would. I thought being part-time would be easier, and that, you know, I'd have all this extra time to do stuff, including the video. But turns out all I do with the extra time is play Destiny and mope. I promised myself I was going to do all these things to the channel. Stopped me doing things. So, I mean, I'm in the kind of mood where if I manage to shower and get my bag ready for work, that's a victory day. And, well, some people view that as pretty lazy, you know, that's how it is. And that's why I've not done any video editing. I mean, this, you know, I can just upload it. is I've been planning this for 4 days. And I finally did it. I showered and thought, right, I can do this. So here I am. So it's a half-task video. But I thought someone may like it. So I have the stuff. Why is there a car? Set. I'm just gonna kind of do it as and when I upload it. That's how I've done it for the last couple of years. As I may do it beforehand. I am going to be running another competition soon. And I don't know what the prize is. I don't know if there'll be a prize other than showing it off. But what it's gonna be is another series of make artwork for me. But this time for depression, some alternatives to self-harming. I was thinking about doing a dignitas roleplay, self-harm discovery, maybe some doctor stuff, we'll see. Of course I say this, whether I do it or not, it doesn't matter. As for my mental health status, now I've got some more free time from work, I thought I ought to try to some therapy. Now, in my city, there's something called Talking Changes, which is offers. It just looks like a collar. Which offers cognitive behavioral therapy. And, by phone, I handed that in, it's self referral. Oh my god. Seriously. It's never this busy. Here you go. I bet it's the same car going up and up and down because he knows I'm filming. And I had a phone call assessment which lasted like an hour. And it, you know, I had to open up and stuff like that's fine. Well, about a week later I get a phone call saying that they don't think they can help me. They think that I need more specific is probably fair, because my medication recently has been giving me stroke-like. Sorry, I'm using my laptop slight. It's been giving me like stroke-like symptoms. Like I forget things all the time. I could be halfway through something, I'll forget. My cognitive skills are fucking awful. I'll forget a word halfway through. I have trouble picking things up, which when I'm serving people on till in a shop, you can guess it's awkward when I'm trying to open a bag and I'm sitting there going. So, I got this through. I just dragged this side off the phone and realised there's not a camera there. NHS is very good at referring people on. And I got a letter through from my doctors saying they want to see me because they're worried about my self-harm behaviours and my suicidal ideation. And I had to laugh because I've been going to see them because of this for the last 10 years. And, I'm starting to date. I've always joked about my mental health and I've always made light of it. And I kind of feel like, although I'm open about it, where it doesn't, you know, where I kind of keep it to me, I don't know. I'm open up about it, about the fact I suffer, but I don't tell people when I'm suffering or why I'm suffering, you know. I just kind of nod off and say, I'm not very good or I'm in a bad mood or something. But recently that filter has disappeared and now I've been going onto Facebook and Twitter and just bitching about life, not moaning, just saying what's the point in it. It's been getting a lot of unwanted attention and it's shit I shouldn't have done, but it's kind of forced me to realise that I'm not as okay as I think I am. I need to do something about it. But the thing is, they also sent me through the post a list of self-harm alternatives, and I've got something to show you. The list of self-harm. Now, this one's my favourite. I don't know if you can see this properly, but it says, hit pillows or cushions, or have a good cream into a pillow or cushion to vent anger and frustration. Now, I'm assuming that's meant to say scream. But a good cream into a cushion. It fucking creased me up. I was laughing so much when I read that. But I'm awaiting a response from them. But they sent me through a personal safety plan, which is a contract I'm meant to sign. Personal safety plan as agreed with my clinician. It says what will trigger me to feel low or hurt to myself, and it has a list of the triggers I said when we had that conversation with the assessment. Apparently it says when I feel like hurting myself or feel suicidal, I will do one of three things: have a coffee, listen to music, keep myself occupied. I can understand these contracts for a teenager, you know, or I guess someone who is, you know, easily swayed maybe, but I'm a 32-year-old man and they want me to sign a contract saying that I won't hurt myself. Now, I like to joke and say, I'm a man, if I want to kill myself, I'll kill myself. But if I kill myself, my wife will kill me. This isn't a very happy video, is it, I'm afraid? This is the whole late making light of it. Short-term strategies I use to keep myself safe. Keep the Samaritans number. Now, the Samaritans are a British suicide helpline. And they are amazing. They are absolutely amazing. They have been so helpful to me over the years. And I have tried to do some volunteer work for them. Not to sit on the phones and talk to people, because I don't have the right temperament, or I wouldn't be able to deal with it. But I want to get in with the fundraising and stuff, so I'm waiting to hear back from that because I've got some free time. But yeah, if you're ever feeling bad, they are amazing. But there's another bit here that says positive things to remember when I feel like hurting myself or feel suicidal. I have coped this far. I have the strength to continue. Hope for improvement. How is that? How is that positive thing to remember? To hope for improvement. I will feel better once I've got through this. This is bullshit. Absolute bullshit. And impact of suicide on loved ones. They finish that off with guilt. Now, I know the idea of it is to help me. And I am a cynical bastard. Yes, I am. Just, we all have our coping mechanisms, you know. I don't self-harm too often. You know, I kind of, when I feel my mood dipping, I'll go for coffee, because episodes when they happen can be fun. I can have a lot of energy. I will bounce around. I'll at work. I will sing when I'm on deal. Sing my heart out in the warehouse. And when I was in charge, a manager, that was fine because you know who's going to judge the guy in charge. But now I'm a supervisor. I'm being bossed around by people 10 years younger than me, which was going to happen eventually. But it's something I'm struggling with. That's fine, you know. I made some mistakes. I've got to swallow my pride and get on with it. But when mania is mixed in with suicidal ideation, it gets fucking messy. And on Friday night, I finished work at 11:30 at night. I got home about 11:45 and decided that I needed to distract myself because my wife wasn't in and I had to do something to try and kill the energy and to stop about doing something stupid. So I cleaned the house, and over the next 2 nights, I cleaned our house. Spotless it was. Now, I'm a messy person, not unhygienic, but I let things build up. And I cleaned the oven twice, I cleaned the kitchen floor 3 times, I just... my wife got home half drunk at 1 o'clock in the morning on Friday, and I was on the stairs hoovering. My neighbours must have hated us. So yeah, that was fun. But these are things I've done. And mental health sucks, man. It does. I have a job interview this week, actually. Working for the Salvation Army as a night home concierge at a homeless shelter. It's different, but you know, it's a practical job, but at least it'll be one that will help people. Even if it is just signing them in and out and cleaning, I'm okay with that. It'll be a job that matters. I've applied to university to study social care because I want to get into mental health. You know, I want to help people the way they've helped me, and I want to help people in ways that I wasn't helped. You know, I've received great help. I've received great help, and I've received awful, awful help. You know, just people that didn't give a shit, they were just doing it for the job. And I never want to let anyone experience that. I want to help them. And whether I do that in my spare time by, you know, just doing the practical bits for, you know, these companies or charities, then, you know, I'm helping out. Now, before I go, it has been mentioned quite a lot recently in some comments that I don't wear tops. And there's a reason for that. I like to be comfortable when I make these videos now. The name Drunk ASMR came, obviously, because I'd get tanked roleplay, but I don't tend to do that so much anymore, so maybe it's time for a name change. Should I stick with Drunk ASMR? Should I change it? Someone tell me, because these are decisions I'm not in the right mind to make. But the reason I don't wear t-shirts is tops in these videos these days is because when I'm at home I don't wear tops. I just wander around in my pajama bottoms or tracksuit bottoms, or my, all my jeans, and that's just how I am. My wife will have people come home, when she comes home with a friend, and they'll walk in, and I'm just there, in my chair, in my jeans, and they're just kind of stood there really awkwardly as I'm going, "Hi, how you doing?" They've got this big fat man kind of looking at them, and when I get people in my house, I don't know, I'm quite hostile. Territorial. I just don't like people in my house. And, you know, they've got me there, topless, going, it may as well be in a heap, going. So that's why I don't wear tops. Plus, apparently, it's how you get, you know, viewers, so. On this note, it's 21 minutes, so I was only intended to do a 5-minute video. And I'm going to there, and keep an eye out for other videos, because, you know, I've got some pre-made that I might be updating, I could upload, but they're just kind of boring soundtrack videos, and I'm kind of bored of those kind of things. I don't even watch it myself anymore. So, on that note, I'm going to leave you goodbye, and just to make you feel awkward, mwah. Is there anything I can do to help you relax? To help you sleep at all? If I just stroke you with a brush, does that make you feel better? I'm here talking to a headless mannequin head. You need to get a new haircut. That one is not good. Undecided whether this is roleplay or a mistake, apparently. But the important thing is the up close whispering and the personal attention, I guess. I do not appear to be very good at making proper ASMR videos, so I thought I'd give it a chance this time. Unfortunately, as was requested by the competition winner, Matt, and it hasn't turned out very well at all, so I thought I'm going to edit it and upload it anyway, but the I may have to remake it. Seems to be okay. I'm using the Amazon Fire phone. this is a slightly breathy one, and that it's not too bad sound quality. So if it is good sound quality, tell me, and for the price of it, for the phone, and if it works well as a camera, I might not have to bother with a dedicated one. But we can see how it goes. I have the window open for a bit of natural light, because you can see the sun coming up slightly. Although it's England, so you know, it's the grey clouds. I had to go into a shop the other day. The Hitler mannequin is not working very well in general, but on the phone, because I made it for the much bigger LG Flex. And it's difficult to buy a tripod that isn't about that big for the phones, so I bought a selfie stick now, and it made me feel, I was so like, selfie sticks, and the guy behind the counter just kind of looked at me, and I had to say, well, I made an excuse, and I said, oh, I use my phone for vlogging, and you know, this is the best way to hold it, and to be honest, it's really good, it holds it really well, and if I can solidate the stick to my normal mannequin, outside my normal tripod, which is a decent tripod, then it should work really, really well. Selfie stick for no reason, but it's one of the button ones, so it's really pointless, so it's cheap. So if you hold it out too far, you can't take the selfie because you can't reach the fucking phone. yourself off to sleep whilst I look at the screen awkwardly and try to turn off the phone. Good night, and I hope you enjoyed it. for making it to the end of this video. If you would like to put down a like, subscribe, click one of these links around.